is not easy, but the grace of God is sufficient. I'd like us to pray, then we allow the other team to come in, the immediate family members can remain as others come in.
Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, this is a very difficult moment for the Awandaba family, the Captain family, for all of us, their relatives and friends. We confess that it's difficult because we are human beings, and it's not easy for us to understand why our brother should leave us at this point. But we are privileged when we can come before you and give you our burdens and tell you exactly how we feel and ask of you to touch us where nobody else can touch us, to heal us, to strengthen us, to comfort us, to assure us of your presence. I pray for each family member. Come to each one in a very special way at this time. May they know that you care for each one. We thank you for Oliver's own family. We pray for them, Heavenly Father. Surround them with your love and with your comfort. We thank you that when we pray, you hear us and you answer. For it's in Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. Amen. The immediate family members, you can just move behind a bit so that we can come with you. And if you can sit, you can sit here. Sister, sit here. Sister, sit here. Sister, another sit here.
It is well. It is well with my soul. With my soul.
It is well. You can sit so that another person can come in. Let's have others coming in. Another group can come in. You can come and view, then you leave to allow others to come in.
It is well. It is well with my soul. With my soul. It is well. It is well with my soul. Salama,
salama,
Roni, Pamoja, pamoja, pamoja.
final prayer, and then we leave. So allow me to pray. Again, I want to say sorry to the family. It is not easy. But the Bible says in the book of Thessalonians, chapter number 4, that as we mourn, we should mourn as people knowing what has happened and where our brother has gone. It is not easy to comprehend, but surely God calls us at his appropriate time, and when he calls us, we go and rest with him. So our brother Oliver is resting with the Lord. Those of us who are remaining here have the pain, but my prayer is that you'll be comforted as you go through this difficult time of mourning. May the grace of the Lord be upon you. Let's pray. Father, we thank you. We thank you this evening. Indeed, God, we know it is not easy for this family. But Jehovah, Lord, your grace is sufficient. We call on you and you hear us. There is nothing impossible with you. Father, you knew the life of Oliver and you called him a time like this. Father, he has left behind our family. He has left behind brothers and sisters. He left behind parents, aunts, uncles, nephews, nieces, and cousins, oh Lord, and anybody who is called by their name. I want to thank you, Jehovah, Lord, because I know it is not easy for them. Following what happened to them this year, Father, it's not easy for them to understand, but we know you have answer to every question. Father, may you walk with them closely. May you hold their hands, oh Lord. May you be in their hearts, King of all glory. A time like this, you are the only Redeemer that is remaining. May you redeem this family. May you comfort them. May you guide them through this time. May you, Father, help them as they go through this time of bereavement, Jehovah. May your will be done. Father, we thank you because you gave the family members journey masses, and now the body of Oliver is here. They are planning to travel tomorrow to Kitale. Father, we pray for journey masses. We pray for protection. Even the day of the burial, we commit it unto you. May you help this family through this moment. We thank you, Jehovah, because you are faithful. We pray for your comfort. We pray for your guidance. We pray for your will. May you be with us today. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Thank you. So we say, Paula, I request you go back to the tent. We make a final prayer as we plan for tomorrow. Thank you.
The pain of losing.
not coming. Have a prayer. Have a prayer.
I'll now hand over to Pastor Walter. Thank you very much, Pastor.
Thank you. Yeah, I want to say pole to all of us. Indeed, it is not easy, as I said in the beginning. Losing a family member, a brother, is not an easy experience. The Lord knows what you are going through. And I want just to remember that a few months ago we were here when we lost one of you, our sister Belinda. And maybe in your heart you may be having questions on why this is happening. But I stand as the servant of God to pray that may God be with you. And we stop any instance of death in this family in the name of Jesus. Pray that God may give you life. And those who are remaining, don't fear, because the Lord is your strength. The Bible says the name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run to it and they are saved. So I want to declare an Abbo's family is protected in the blood of Jesus. And no weapon fashioned against you will prosper, because God is your strength. The Bible says, but I do not want you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning those who have fallen asleep, lest you sorrow as others who have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so God will bring with him those who have slept in Jesus. For this we say to you by the word of the Lord, that we who are alive and remain until the coming of the Lord will by no means precede those who are asleep. For the Lord himself will descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trumpet of God, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And thus we shall always be with the Lord. Therefore, comfort one another with these words. Those who have gone before us are just resting in the Lord. And one day, Oliver will rise. We shall meet with him as we meet Jesus Christ. So may that be your confidence as you come to term with what has happened, and may God comfort you. I want us to stand, and if there are any believers in this group, I want you to pray for this family, that the Lord may stop any spirit of death, anything that is following them, in the name of Jesus. So let us stand. Just take 1 minute. We protect this family in the blood of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Just speak a word to this family, that the Lord may give them life. The Lord may give them surety of life, in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. We thank you, Lord. We speak life. We speak life in the name of Jesus. We speak life in this family in the name of Jesus. We speak restoration. We speak peace in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we declare this family will live to declare your goodness and mercies in the name of Jesus. Life belongs to you. In the name of Jesus. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, we are standing in your presence. Father, I declare that this family will live to see your goodness. I declare life in this family. I declare prosperity. I declare the peace of God. Father, I declare good health. In the name of Jesus, we cancel every powers of sicknesses. And we are declaring that everybody in this family will live to declare your goodness. We pray for the parents. We pray for the aunts. We pray for the uncles. We pray, Father, for everybody in this family, the brothers and sisters to Oliver. I declare that they are going to live, oh God. I declare you're going to give them hope even through this time, oh God. May you give them hope, oh God. May you give them surety, and may you lead them. Thank you this time. As we come to the end, may you be with us. We shall be leaving this place, going to different destinations, oh Lord. I pray for journey masses. I pray for your protection. Be with us today. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Thank you. God bless you.
All right. A very, very big thank you to Pastor Walter. For the reason we gathered here, we have actually completed the assignment. And so all I'll be giving is just a little guide with regards to the plans going forward. Once I'm done with speaking, guests shall be free to leave at their pleasure. And for those who are traveling with us tomorrow, we shall be convening here and leaving at 7. With regards to the route, I'm sure we all know the way to Kitale, and we all know where we are going. So without any further ado, let me take this opportunity on behalf of the family to again thank you very, very sincerely for making time to be with us today as we've paid our respects to Oliver, and also for holding us on this long journey from the time when we got the news that Oliver had departed. Thank you very much, and have a blessed evening. appreciate the whole event.
Thank you. Tomorrow is long.
Ready for the 6.